Next, we're going to use our aggregate demand and aggregate supply model to analyze an economic expansion. So we start with our initial equilibrium at the intersection of long-run aggregate supply, short-run aggregate supply, and our aggregate demand curve. Our output is a potential output, so there is no cyclical unemployment. Our economic expansion started from an increase in our aggregate demand. So consumption goes up, investment goes up, so aggregate demand shifts to the right. As a result, price level goes up, output goes up. So now our output, Y2, is higher than the potential output, meaning our unemployment rate is lower than the natural rate of unemployment. So our economy is running at unsustainable level. Here is what happens to our economy in the long run if neither the government nor the Federal Reserve's our central bank does anything to intervene. In the long run, short-run aggregate supply curve is going to shift to the left, restoring our real GDP back to its potential with a higher price level. So here is why. We know that we were in economic expansion, so the price level goes up and output goes up. As a result, the workers are going to turn to their employer and say, hey, the price level has gone up. So for me to continue to work for you, you must increase my wage. So the wage goes up, meaning the input price goes up. Now the input price goes up, firms will say that, hey, the input price is so high, so maybe I should produce less. So our short-run aggregate supply curve will shift to the left. And as a result, that will restore our real GDP back to its potential.